Hi everyone, so happy you stopped by to see a new video of us. My name is Yanni and I am welcome you to our channel which I'm hosting with my daughter-in-law Diane. But today I am doing the challenge which is called Trash to Treasure Challenge, which is hosted by the beautiful Casey from Coffee with My Sunshine and Jessica from Mesra Mix. They both have beautiful channels, and of course I will put a link down below for both their beautiful channels. And of course, I will put a link down below for the playlist with all the beautiful creators who are joining Casey and Jessica in this great challenge. And of course, I also try to make from trash something beautiful. So I hope you like my DIY. And if you like our videos and if you like our channel, I hope you will consider subscribing to our channel. And if you do, give it a thumbs up and click the bell so you will be notified every time we upload a new video. So enough talking, let's jump into the DIY. So here you see my trash item. Of course it is a little clock, but it always reminds me of a pocket watch like my grandfather always had in his pocket. Of course it is a bigger it is a bigger form, but he always reminds me of that, so I am really sad that it is broke. You see here, if you see the here in the Netherlands we call it the wijzers, they are broken, which they give on the time. So but I will try to make something else out of it. Of course you see here the rounding is very distressed and I like it that way, so I'm going to try to give also this a little tray also a distressed feeling. So I will paint it and of course then I will distress it. This will be my second time I only distressed something with my beads. So this will be my second time, so I hope it will turn out right. But let's start our DIY. So first what I will do with this little tray, I will make some with some tape. Here in the Netherlands we call it afdek tape, but I don't really think how you call it in English, but I think you know what I mean. I mean, I'm going to make some stripes out of on my tray, and then I will spray paint it. So then you get some stripes, and then after that I spray paint it, I will distress it. So let's first do on the tape. So everything is the first time for me, because I never did the stripes, and I never did distress a tray. Of course, like you, if you are already here for a while, you know that I distressed my beads, my garden, Christmas garden, with our beads. So you know, then I did that. But this is the first time I will do this one. I will stand up with it so I can see that if I am correctly. But I have to do it, of course, I have to be really so I hope it will the way I have it in my head, of course, and that the stripes won't will be totally out of. Get it over here. I only do this one so you don't get bored when I all the time doing this with the tape. So I only just show you a little bit how is one tape, and now I will do, of course you understand the way I'm going to, and here is a little smaller one. I will do it under it and maybe above it. I don't know yet, I have to see, but I think you know already what I mean, so I won't bore you with that. So I show you when I'm done with everything. So you see how I taped him now. I think I go for three lines, a bigger one and two small ones, but maybe if I don't like it, I leave this one away. The only bad thing is that my tray is not even in the inside, so if you have it right above, then it will walk away a little bit because, yeah, of course, it's a little bit of a cheap tray because he was only $2.49, so he is not really well made, so the wood is a little bit going in the wrong direction, so he's not completely straight. So, but I'm doing my best, so it is a little bit of a task to get the tape on it, but if you have on it, and now I hope when I spray paint it, that it will turn out right, but we will see. Let's spray paint now. So this is how he looks like after one coat. I hope I can show it to you a little bit in the light. Of course, he needs a couple of coats more, but this is one. Now I will spray paint the second one. So now, this is the moment of truth. I hope it will turn out right under the tape, but I don't know. I have a little bit of a feeling that the tape is a little bit, I hope I can show it to you. Oh my. He only a little bit over here, but if the other one are that great, I will be very happy. Of course, he a little bit. And here also a little bit under, I think it turned a dip when I did the backside. I think he just got a little bit under it. Now the large one. I hope he is also, and this for the first time. I'm a little bit afraid here in the corners that he is got a little bit paint under it. Oh, this corner is, oh, I do it this way so I can show you. I hope I can show you the best. Oh, this for me just just a surprise for the first time. Oh, I think he's this is how he looks like. The paint didn't go under it, but I still find it sad that the wood is that cheap that that they didn't have the lines across. But I think he turned out for the first time. I think he turned out great. But maybe I am really a little bit too harsh for myself, because overall he turned out great. For the first time, he really turned out great. And if you could have in mind that he is only €2.79, if I'm correct. Yeah, I think 79 or 250. At least it between 250 and €3, so for a little tray, a wooden tray, you can say nothing about it. So I think it turned out. Now we're going to start with our, of course, my trash item. Of course, the clock, you can already see the if you call wijzers, I don't know how you call it in English. So I did look it up and they called what we call you in the Netherlands wijzers van de klok. You call it clock, the hands of the clock. At least if my Google is right. So you see they are broken. So, but I still like the shape of it, and like I told you earlier, for me the shape is brings also a little memory. So I like I'm sad that it's broken, but I'm going to try to make something in between that I think will look great. Of course, I printed some items out of Google, and of course some color. I don't know if I will use the pink or the green one. I think I will do it a little bit more in the green style. So let's turn this one. Check out if I can get him out before I break everything. But I think if I don't know if I hope I do it right. They say they can take it out, but I don't know if I can get this one out. We will have to see. I will do that out of camera because you will be very bored if you see me trying for a half hour. So I will do see you in a moment. So this is how it looked like when you're trying already for half an hour, how it will look like. So I'm going back to trying again to get it out. So a little update. You see here already a while later. I don't get the inside with everything I try get it out in one piece. You see already I broke already a lot of pieces, but if I do more then he will break also the plastic frame on front, and that's not what I want. So I already have first glue it together because this one is also turning inside out, and that means that your picture also will be turning every time, so that's not a great thing. So I tried with the normal glue, but of course that didn't work. So I did my second hand glue and this seemed to work, but of course like a thing, use gloves because or else you will be stuck on your clock. And I don't think that's the way you want it. So, but I think he is staying right now. So now we can work on the front side to make it again a new decor piece. So now first I will make the size of my clock. I think I go for the green color. I measured a little bit and it's almost the same size as my little charger for under my glasses. So of course I will cut it out. Sorry, I know this part will be very boring for some of you. And most of the time I try to keep everything what you already know a little bit shorter. So now I have to look how much he is too big. So you see already he is already too big. So we do a little side. On the side a little piece, but then it's always the question when you do that that he probably will be too small for it's too small for inside of your. So we will see, and I hope he still is a little bit round. Of course, that's not too bad. He still is a little bit too big. Not much, but a little. But I still hope I'm not. He's already a little bit more. I think he's, when I do it with Mud Pot, I think he will be, this, the size will be great. Now I will have a little bit of the corners, because I see I have a little bit, I don't know how you call it. We here in the Netherlands say wat puntjes eraan, maar I don't know if you how you call it. That he is not really a nice round. So I hope he's a little bit better right now. So now we can mud podge it and we can get it in. So you see already I have cut out of the camera already a second one. Maybe one piece can be a little bit light. So it will go go through with the with the inside of my clock, so you can still can in the light you can still through it, because the paper is not very thick. So I will try first one coat with Mud Podge, and then I will see if I need something more. He still falls inside of my I'm trying to push so many air out of my that I can. I'm sorry, I don't show it to you, but I will show it to you in a moment. But I'm trying to get it a little bit even and under the, so you don't see a corner here, and it will be a nice finish, because I hate it when the finish is not very nice. So you see already a little bit where I'm going for. So I let this dry for a while, for a moment. Of course I will do the second one coat on it, and then I will show it to you how it is with the first coat. But we have to see. And then he has to dry for a moment. And then I will see if I do the second one, at least the second paper. So this dries. So now I am, so far it's a little bit dried, but now I'm far. So far I cut it out the chicken already, because or else you had to wait too long. Of course I use this chicken, but of course you can find on Google the most beautiful chickens you like. I like this one, so I cut it out. I'll show you a little bit with the background. I cut this one out, and I also will mud podge this one also on my clock, at least the clock that it was. Oh, I already oh my. Okay, now you see crafting is not without a risk. Of course my brushes are already falling out of each other. So I do a little bit on the chicken, but I also do a little bit on my, so he will be a little bit, stick a little bit better. Now I have to stand up if I that I'm doing him correct. Of course, I hope you can see it. So a little bit. I will not do too much on the black, because or else you walking the risk that he will go through on your green, and that's not what you want. So this is how he looks right now. Maybe I do something else with it, but I have to see how much space I have. But I let this dry also here again. So now my little chicken dried up. So I will lie him beside a little bit. So now I'm going to try to, with a little, here we say schuurpapier. So I try to distress it a little bit. This is also for me the first time. I'm always very scared that I distress it too much. I really have no idea. So I think I leave it this way. Now I'm going to try to measure where I want my little clock ones, a little bit, at least beside the stripes. I think this is the height I was going for. So now I will glue it together, because or else he will fall down, and I don't want to use a nail. So I glue this one in the tray, and of course I have my gloves on for the second hand glue. So first I will do let it dry a little bit. So in a moment I will turn it on my tray. Now I have to wait a little moment, and then I hope he will stick and that not the wood is taking all the glue, so he still will be loose. But I hope it will stick right now. But I have to let it dry, even when they say it's second glue, second dries, but most of the time I only when you don't want to stick it on your fingers, then it will stick on your fingers. I know from experience. So you see already a little bit how he looks like. So when this is drying, it's already dry, because when you see, I can already lift it up already. But I will do this one over here. Now I want to make a little bow with some black and white plaid. So I'm going to try, because I am not a bow maker. So don't judge me on my on my bows, because they are really bad. I know there are so many easier ways than what I do. So just, and of course I will do a little. Also these ribbons are very thick, and you can buy them in a lot of measurements also on AliExpress, and they are very cheap, and they are really, the fabric is really great. So if you still like it, just leave a comment down below and I will give you the link. They have them in blue and white, gray and white, black and white, and red and white, and I thought light blue and white. So if you want them, just tell me and I will give you the link. So I will see if I like this bow, or else I will do another one. So now I will glue it also again with some second glue. I just do a little drop. Now we have to see if he will stay on it. Maybe I still, I think I like also when I attach it to here, but I don't know yet, and I don't know if I like the bow, so we will see. But we will first, I want to do some letters over here. I have some stickers. So I first will do some letters over here. So you see, I have the stickers in it. So this is a little bit how he turned out. Of course, I don't really know if I really like the bow. So, but I leave it for this moment, and then I will show you how I decorated it on another tray. But this was my trash to treasure. So you see, something from trash you still can use for something in your home. I think it turned out quite nice, and for the distressing was my first time and I really enjoyed it, but I still have something in my head. You are destroying something you just made. But I did my best. Now I show you how easy it is just to make a simple little centerpiece or a little tray for in your kitchen or for on your table. It doesn't matter. Just also, this is the bigger one of the little tray. This one was I think around the 5 euro. Also very inexpensive. So of course I will do this one also here. You know, everyone who knows me a little bit, I love fur for the coming September, and of course for the winter season is coming. I already have new colors already, but you will see that in that time. So I will use just a simple tray. I have some of course my distressed beads. I just lay them. I'm sorry for the noise. I make a lot of noise and my dishwasher makes noise, so we make a lot of noise together. So of course I will use this one over here, and if I leave it this way, then I will make it with some sticky gum, so I'm certain that he won't fall off, because if you know, move this around, because you eat at this table, so then he will fall off every time. So then I will do some sticky gum under it, but for now I leave it this way. Of course, I do a little touch of greenery. I also can have some lambs here. Just maybe I do that. I just not really know. So I do a piece around at the back. Don't forget the back. A lot of people always do everything beautiful in front and then they don't forget the back, because if you move around it, you will see also the back of my little centerpiece. Of course, some little flowers. They are, this one I bought, I think, from IKEA from $4.99, but that was already last year. So I have one of them, and I have one of this one, if he will work with me. Here in the Netherlands we call it blauwe druifjes. Of course, they are also in the blue color, but I have this one in the white. And I bought this one in a garden center. It doesn't say the price anymore, but I thought they were around €3. So I do a little bit beside this one. And of course, I will use my little cactus. I did some furniture bags on it. So he got the brown color, more than more of the rustic color. But of course, I have him also in black. But this time I will choose for to bring it a little bit the brown color back. Of course, I have a closure, but I will do some greenery around my closure. This is always a task to get it under the closure, because this is not a very big opening, but if you work a little bit with it, it will be fine. So you see, he's already under it. So now I will use this two little chickens. Of course, a little bit is the same as I have in my little sign. And of course, I painted them in the black color. They were really like a chicken color, if I can say chicken color, chicken color. But of course, I painted them in the black color, and I will do one over here and one over here in the corners. So I just do a little greenery behind here. And just a little between the chickens, and of course, because I always think my pieces are coming a little bit more to life. Of course, I do some little piece of greenery over here. Just a little touch, not a lot. I think here you have has already enough. And of course, also at the back, some pieces of, like we call here, hetshorn. They are so easy to work with. So if you have greenery, don't throw it away. Just pull everything out. If you have plants or whatnot, like this, like I did with my ferns from IKEA, just pull them out. And you have a lot of fun afterwards with the pieces you still have. Little touches of this green. I always love a little bit here in the back. Let's not forget. And of course, some ivy leaves. Just a little bit inside of your tray. And of course, also here at the back side. And I will do it on the other side also in a moment. But now you see, with a little pieces of decor, you can make a piece for your own, and you can make your own unique piece. That's what I always say. Try to make a unique piece for yourself. So I think he turned out quite nice. I show you in a moment, better from close, how he turned out. You see here, I took a little sign for a moment out of my tray, because when I was putting my garbage away, I thought I found my two hands of the clock again. So if anyone who has pieces use can see also afterwards, you can also use the hands of the clock still. So if you have old hands of your clock, don't throw them away, but maybe you in a later moment you can use them with something in your decor. I don't know if I will use it in this one, but I just wanted to show you that you can use it afterwards. So when I would use it, I have to spray paint it, because I don't love the color which is white now, so I have to spray paint it. But I just wanted to show you that you still can use it. So this was my DIY for the Treasure Tracer for the month of May. You see, I already have it on my table. I hope you enjoyed watching my DIY. And of course, thank you Casey and thank you Jessica for hosting this great challenge. I had a lot of fun. And I hope when you watch this, I hope you also enjoyed seeing how I make my DIY and how I decorated it. If you do, click the red button and subscribe to our channel. We would love to have you here. And from Diane and me, please stay safe, take care of yourself and take care of each other. And we hope to see you in another video. Love from Diane and me. Bye everyone.